When considering the domain of anti-missile laser systems, the United States Navy demonstrates a steadfast preparedness to deploy these advanced technologies, even if it involves deploying such systems on its naval vessels. The outgoing leader of the Navy's Surface Warfare Unit, Riar Adam, Ron Boxall, shared that the Navy plans to equip the Hawaii-based destroyer Preble with the high-energy laser and integrated optical dazzler with surveillance system, Helios, in 2021. He likened this event to the historical example of Spanish explorer Hernan Cortez, who deliberately sank his ships to inspire his crew. An onboard laser designed to replace our current systems, Boxall explained in a May interview with Defense News. He drew a parallel to the historical example of Cortez and his burning boats, signifying a commitment to victory by moving ahead, he emphasized. Likewise, we're choosing to integrate lasers onto our DDGs. The initiative commences with the Preble in 2021, thereby establishing it as the new close-in weapon system undergoing ongoing enhancements. Lockheed Martin is creating Helios, a strong laser that starts at 60 kilowatts but can eventually reach 150 kilowatts. This company also makes the Aegis combat system used on destroyers. The laser will be combined with the combat and power systems, making our Navy even more capable. The U.S. Navy has unveiled its mightiest laser in action, effectively obliterating a target drone in mid-flight. Referred to as the MK2 Mod Zeroi, this impressive technology is also recognized as the Solid-State Laser, Technology Maturation Laser Weapon System Demonstrator, LWSD, and it's situated aboard the amphibious ship USS Portland. The LWSD undoubtedly stands out as the most commanding and formidable laser system to be deployed at sea. The LWSD, a creation of the Office of Naval Research and Northrop Grumman, has been successfully installed on the amphibious transport dock USS Portland. Notably, the LWSD boasts an impressive output of 150 kilowatts, rendering it up to 5 times more potent than other lasers deployed by the Navy. The Laser Weapon System, LAWS, operational on the USS Ponce since 2014, was noted to have an output of 30 kilowatts, which proved sufficient to neutralize small drones. The Optical Dazzling Interdictor, Navy, Odin, laser, newly integrated into the guided missile destroyer USS Dewey, is specifically engineered for downing drones and disturbing electro-optical sensors. Given its purpose, it is likely to possess a comparable level of power to the LAWS system. With an impressive output of 150 kilowatts, the MK2 Mod Zero represents a significant advancement in power output compared to earlier laser weaponry. A Navy-released video vividly showcases the laser's successful interception of an unmanned drone while airborne. According to a report by the Lexington Institute, a 150 kilowatt weapon would possess the capacity to effectively counter various threats such as unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, small boats, rockets, artillery, and mortars. There's much we still don't know about LWSD, especially how far it can shoot targets. A system like CRAM, which uses missiles, can hit similar targets from about 6 miles away, but lasers can be affected by things like rain, dust, smoke, or particles in the air, which can make them less effective at burning holes in targets from a long way off. Installing an aircraft disabling laser on an amphibious transport ship might sound unusual, especially since ships like the San Antonio class usually carry hundreds of U.S. Marines for amphibious missions. The decision to equip the USS Portland with the laser, as reported by Defense and Aerospace Report, was due to the available space that was originally designed for vertical launch missile silos, but was never utilized, along with the advantage of pre-existing electrical infrastructure on the ship that facilitated the laser's integration. While the LWSD serves as a technology demonstrator, it is rapidly narrowing the gap with missile-based systems currently in use by the U.S. Navy. Notably, a laser weapon system has the potential to fire an unlimited number of shots, a significant contrast to systems like CRAM, which has a magazine capacity limited to 11 missiles. A single CRAM missile comes with a significant cost, amounting to thousands of dollars each, whereas lasers are primarily powered by the fuel needed to operate the laser, often amounting to mere pennies per shot. The Navy's latest laser technology is not yet prepared to replace weapons like CRAM. To become an operational weapon system, it must undergo ruggedization to endure the challenges of constant movement during a ship's voyages. This involves withstanding the corrosive effects of salt water, which is a constant challenge for seafaring vessels due to rust. Additionally, the LWSD lacks the requisite power to eliminate larger manned aircraft, and crucially, it cannot intercept incoming anti-ship missiles. to neutralize larger, swiftly moving targets, a more potent laser is essential to prompt structural failure within a shorter time frame. With that said, thank you for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and stay tuned for more.